Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the countdown to Bayonetta 3. Right now, we're picking up where we left off at Chapter 12, The Broken Sky. This is Part 4 of our Bayonetta 1 playthrough. We're just doing a casual playthrough where whatever collectibles or anything that I find along the way, I'll pick up. But we're just not redoing chapters to get more collectibles. Eventually I will come back to Bayonetta though and go to one of my old save files just so we can get a completionist run where we get all the collectibles. Alright, but yeah, let's go ahead and start Chapter 12, The Broken Sky. Got one of my cats crying in the background, but I promise he just does that all the time.
Excuse me, sir. May I have my glasses back?
Huh? Oh, yeah. Here you go. Cereza, how did you get such magical glasses?
The glasses aren't magic, silly. I can see the monsters without them.
Monsters? Quite. So, has Bayonetta, I mean your mom, been fighting these big bad monsters for a long time?
Mummy is a witch, and witches protect people and are very strong. When I grow up, I'll be strong too, and I'll protect my mummy.
Wait, you think witches do what? Oh, forget it. No point in arguing with a little kid. I'll manage on my own.
I'm sure you will. Amuse me, Cheshire. I suppose that's your next target?
I know a lot of people are using that scene of Cereza being like, I'm gonna be big and strong like Mummy. I'm wondering if they're actually gonna include that clip at all in Bayonetta 3. Oh, that's so cute.
Good.
Bayonetta, no matter how I ask, no matter how many times, always say the same thing.
Come now, Kitty. You know it was
a misunderstanding. You're so stubborn, you know that? My father, he was a journalist too. In fact, he was twice the man I could ever hope to be. He was obsessed with one case his entire career. A case so bizarre it took over his life. Could have made a movie of the details. The followers of darkness, the Umbra witches, and their light world counterparts.
Hey, they made three games so far and a movie about it.
The power known as the Eyes of the World. Then, the Light and Dark clans suddenly disappeared from their medieval home in Europe. You may be familiar with the town. You're standing in it. Welcome to Vigrid. 500 years later.
500 years?
Each clan, working at the behest of the powers that be, sought to lead their fractured world towards peace. They both possessed an eye said to have the power to create history that they used to oversee the world. However, their spirit of cooperation did not last. For amongst them, a pair of young star-crossed lovers conceived a child that sent the clans on a path to ruin. The woman was thrown in jail, and the man exiled from his clan. However, the child remained with the Umbra, raised as a black sheep even amongst the darkness. Since the balance between light and dark had been lost, both clans spiraled into decay. Legend had it that the two eyes could be united to control reality itself. And this legend fueled ambition and desire, leading to a myriad of battles between the clans. In fact, it led to their mutual destruction. My father was mocked for buying such a fairy tale. However, I believed his story, and I believe it more than ever now that I've found you. The memory of the clan lingers on, despite the passing of 500 years. What on earth was my father searching for? And why did he have to die for it? I have to discover the truth with my own eyes. That's why I haven't given up my chase for it. Or you. The head of the Ithaval group, a multinational that dominates Vigrid, recently tried to sell an enormous gemstone on the black market. If he isn't selling out in the open, it means we're going to have to acquire it by other means. And that starts by sneaking onto that jet.
I think it's kind of silly is that the witches and the Lumen Sages both, for some reason, lived in Vigrid, even though the witches have
Mommy,
pacts with demons,
are you looking for something?
And Vigrid is closest
oh,
to
yeah.
Paradiso.
Where did you lose it?
Little one, do you have anything you really like? Something really important to you?
Cheshire.
Yes, this. I love it.
Where did you get this?
You gave it to me, Mummy. For my birthday.
Never lose it. Understand, little one? You must keep it safe, close to your heart.
I'm curious on how much of this is mocap versus how much is, how much of it is animated with. I think I'm one witch heart away. Whoa! I think I'm one witch heart away from the next health upgrade. From my Wicked Weave, but maybe Jean's. Oh, and there's Gamora. Alright, take that red hot shot. Straight to the floor. book here. I feel like there's something. Okay. Is this where I started? Yeah. I feel like there's a way. There has to be something for backtracking here. Probably after this cutscene. Gauntlets. Whoa. Okay, I didn't realize the verse wasn't over. It's blocking me from going back. But yeah, when, during the break from the last part, we went over to Panera Bread, which was a great reunion with Panera Bread because we haven't had it in a very long time. Might be the best and most affordable, like, fast casual, option, at least in our area. Where's going? Okay, I could see. It wasn't letting us see the enemy, but it did just show us his halo. Oh, they actually opened an Alfheim portal, which I think is going to ruin my sword. Good. I'm not a big fan of out of body battles, but let's go. Oh, and they're flaming. Shit. Let's end this one. But we have to switch weapons for this one. Yeah, let's try. The wood would be nice because we can get some distance. It's just whenever there's a flaming person, if you try to hit it with a direct attack, then it damages you. Pretty early for a torture attack from me, but typically I just get hit right away, so I want to keep the no hit run on this Alpine portal alive as long as possible. Because something like that happened. Jeez. Tricky. Close. Yeah. Really what I need to do... Oh, I lost my backdrop. That's fine. But really what I need to do is... By the way, this is my room. What I need to do is... Save up my torture attack. And then use the chainsaw on the other guy. So yeah, whatever the last one of these is, I want to use my torture attack on. Now the goal is to use my witch time. Use the chainsaw on the big guy. Just to be safe, we're also going to use torture attack on him. No, no, no! Oh my god, they all like focus fired my body. We'll give this one last try, depending on how far I get. Ignoring the fact that I hit him like a million times. More health. Perfect. I think, yeah, there was something up there, so I'm gonna go back for that. We have access to the Gates of Hell, and I kind of want to get the damage increase. Or not the damage increase, just whenever you get hit, you go into Witch Time. I feel like that'd be really useful for boss battles if it works.
How much you ask, I'm not putting a chainsaw on your arm. So what do you want?
You're not putting a chainsaw on my arm? Well, I already have access to chainsaws. Okay, so the Durga is that, but let's see. I think it's accessory. Is it Selene's? Witch Time will be instantly triggered, expanding your magical power whenever I'm attacked. So, yes, please. feels really important. Can you guys activate my witch time, please? Somebody swing at me, please. Ow. I think the only way to get over here was to use the witch time. Even though the angels are unaffected by fans for some reason, I didn't know that that is one of Angel's famous immunities is to fans. Sounds like something fell in the other room. Use wish time, defeat all angels before time expires. Okay. Jeez. Okay. What do I get? Moon Pearl. Nope, another heart. I think I've gotten like 4 hearts in this chapter alone. If not 4, definitely 3. Over here, so I have witch time, please. Ow. Aren't I supposed to be like automatically going into witch time? I might have to equip that still. And yeah, so it was John trying to take down the plane.
Why so glum? Something troubling you? Only your constant fretting over my state of affairs. I've no time to play games with you. No need to take out your stress on me, Bayonetta. It's clear. You're worried for the girl.
He'll never shut up about it, and his whining is twice as irritating as anything the child could muster. You've quite the tongue when it comes to curling round the truth. And what about you? What are you hiding? Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think these might mean something to you. I've no need for worthless junk.
For those who weren't here with the last part, that was a statue that depicted Jean, the girl in red, and Cereza, who is the little girl.
I am well aware of my task, but you have forgotten that I do not need your help.
Again, another, like, these, like, spells and cutscenes would be so cool to know as a character.
Fill your eyes with hate.
Or as a player.
Accept your violent fate. Accept it and earn the left eye. Prove you deserve it.
Also, it's interesting that, like, her wicked weave is white, and she has, like, white feathers on, like, it seems like she's using the feathers that are hanging from her wrist, whereas I use, like, my actual hair. Like, it seems to come from the top of my head. Whoa, it put me way back. that point we were just dancing it. Or... hopefully if I get her to a different health bar, I won't have to go all the way back. Okay, and confirm. I just don't get witch time during this. Oh, yeah, I get witch time when I dodge Gamora, but not when I dodge like her regular attack. Yeah, so witch time whenever I dodge her wicked weaves. Game never explains that, like, certain things I can't use witch time on, at least I don't think it does, so it is a little confusing that, like, I just never know if certain attacks do witch time or certain attacks don't. But specifically with John, I'm pretty sure it's just Wicked Weaves or the motorcycle. Again, for no apparent reason. That was a scary ending because I felt like I hit her over and over again when she was at no health, but it just, none of it went through.
Not yet. She isn't ready.
Sorry, I'm checking for secrets over here. I don't see anything. Also, if I get hit right now, I die. But I made it.
Little one, where are you? Little one, can you hear me?
Cereza!
Time to go, little one. Hold on tight, okay?
Okay.
No way I get out of this alive. Let's see. Okay, well, first of all, we never checked about yet. I have to equip this stuff. Then, second of all, let us concoct something that'll keep us alive instead of just dooming us to death. Ooh. I know it is. I put it off to the side. Definitely didn't need to do this, but I saved the torture text for too long. I'll take the tuba, and then I'll take Sereza. Come on, Sereza, we got band practice. Stream's going good. Can you use the tuba, please? Noted to the tuba takes hecka long, so never use it when you're on a time-sensitive mission. Let's go, Sereza. I think it's boss battle time. I see the reference. What's killing me? What? Those things weren't even on screen yet. I will also, like, Well, if you like the tuba, then get a load of this. Chingisaw is back. But I will say, like, because I was born up, I was born in a VeggieTales household. VeggieTales is very, they have so many, like, Christian spoofs of movies, but all of them, I was never, like, growing up, I was never like, oh, like, I cannot stand this. I was definitely a Larry stan. Even though, like, the show was very, the show and the movie was very clear, like, Larry was, like, annoying Bob, basically for no reason. Larry was just the fun guy. I'm not gonna say that I love Bob, because Bob doesn't really have very many redeeming factors either. Critical Role is streaming. I have not been following Critical Role in a very long time. Not that you're interested. Critical Role, I was actually a really big fan of the first season, but people are like, oh, it gets way better during the second season. But the second season, I think they took it more seriously, and therefore it got a lot more boring. Dementia 20 is holding a, like, really close place in my heart. I'm still, I'm watching all of them in order, and so right now I'm on Crown of Candy. Did you ever, like, watch Critical Role, Bam?
Let's go!
Oh, I didn't know that there was a new Batman game.
Mommy.
Is it based off of
it's okay, little one.
The Twilight
right
guys,
back.
Batman?
Mommy.
this is actually like the hardest boss in the game from what I remember. Oh, Gotham Knights. It's not, if it's, yeah, if it's Batman Gotham Knight, it's like a newer Batman, but it's not new. It's been like years.
Another talkative type. I don't think I've got time to entertain your blabber. I'd much rather hear it straight from your boss.
Yeah, Germa's behind on the times. I was actually really surprised with how the new Batman was. It was a lot better than I thought it was, but it obviously didn't meet expectations. Because it's hard to follow the Christian Bale Batmans. Steampunk angels. Going really well, but we're still early into the first phase. The first angel to like run away from one of our demons. It gave me a QTE that was like, okay, well this is a repetitive QTE. And I was like, oh, just kidding, here's a different QTE. Well, now I just lost my chance. Or no, one of the faces came back, I just have to find it. Okay. Yeah. Have a good time doing laundry. Seen the spider yet. That was good. Thank you. That's our orange cat.
This guy's fucked up.
He's fucked
up.
Nah, he's
good. He's fucked up. What's wrong with you, boy?
One of the great perks of our dryer is that it never actually dries anything. A dryer is just
See, he's fucked up.
He's not fucked up. He's good.
He's all good.
He's all good. This guy looks fucked up to you. This is just a good guy. He's just a man. There's nothing wrong with him. Is there anything wrong with you, son?
I have no idea.
Or are you perfect
why you would
the way
want
you
this
are?
Stone? It would look absolutely terrible on you. Much too flashy. Welcome aboard, Cheshire.
Oh, fucking hell!
Mummy!
I told you I'd be right back. Shouldn't you be, you know, flying this thing? I'm a bit occupied at the moment.
Mommy!
It's not John again, is it?
Well, so much for the subtle approach. You might as well have speakers on this thing blaring Ride of the Fucking Valkyries.
Come now, we're VIPs. You know, nothing says you've made it in life like a private helicopter.
Then welcome aboard Air Luca, Flight 001. This is your captain, Luca, speaking. Fasten your safety belts, as this may be a bumpy flight.
Yeah. So he's so sure that I'm the one that killed his dad, but he's just, like, cracking jokes like, oh, okay, I'm your chauffeur. This man definitely knows. I don't get why it says, like, that the one angel is a mystery, even though I've already seen it out in the wild, so. It doesn't really make sense to, like, keep its identity a secret. A bit of money from that last one, that last round. So if you're like looking to farm halos, I'd say that chapter is probably the one.
You're really not going to like what comes next. I hope you know that.
Don't tell me. Air Chat.
Cheshire has awful in-flight entertainment and horrendous food.
Think about it. Those things that downed the jet aren't just going to let us land on their island. You think we can just say, hey, we're here? They'll bring us a cake? Things look good from up here. But the further down you go, the harder it is to not notice the reality.
Cheshire, look.
Look.
Again, it's like, oh, you killed my dad, but...
Oh, fuck me.
I'm only focused on your looks.
Welcome to my fantasy zone.
Get ready.
That's so cool. Fire guns, fire missile, okay. Missiles expand one of them. One magic gauge. Okay. Noted. Okay, we got it. There is an achievement to... It's either not take damage or to... kill every enemy on this level, and whichever one it is not fun to get up there even. I think it's take no damage. Way more health at this point. I shouldn't have gotten hit that many times. This is not building up. I thought I would be building up my magic gauge as well. And now I have a full car, but I have to be careful not to leave it. I'm getting them, Sereza. I've been saving my torture attacks.
Hurt.
And you guys can't have her. Those guys are honestly probably a better way of building up your torture attacks. I haven't depleted my whole magic gauge, calm down. Over, okay. Expecting another boss battle, so I don't want to use my magic gauge just yet. This one a lot more than the motorcycle. I feel like you have more control over your... You have more control over your character, and like, it feels like the damage that you do actually matters, versus like, on the motorcycle you're just shooting like, bullets, and you have to be shooting at someone for quite a while in order to actually do anything to them. Thank you. had a good bit of magic gauge left, so if there was gonna be a boss, I hope it comes soon.
I'm bringing in some angry babies because I left their dishes to soak in the sink.
They didn't feed them?
Yes, not yet. Not yet.
All I'm hearing is that you teased me.
Huh? Just jumped in. No, that's exactly what's happening. But I got another soak because the rest of the dishes. This guy's pissed.
He's a boo-boo. I won.
This guy is fucking pissed right now. You can tell.
He's pissing his pants is what he's doing.
You can fucking tell this guy's pissed.
I'm not that pissed. I actually love everyone. Hello. There's no music.
Oh, that's awkward.
There was no music, and but when you said, I'm assuming there's music going on, then it started playing, like, opera music.
Oh,
but,
yeah?
But now there's no music.
Okay.
There's still no music. Okay, I'll let you know. Watch this cutscene end, and that's the end of the level.
Welcome to Isla del Sol, island of wealth and power.
Why is there no music?
John.
Because it's an intense cutscene.
That should be enough. You're back to your own self.
John.
We finished what was started so long ago.
Oh gosh. You're supposed to be taking German and you don't even know French names.
A friend of my enemy is also my enemy.
Germany,
be it witch or
sage.
The Lumen Sage.
Yo, why do you want to know a non-romantic language then?
Because fuck the romance languages. All my homies hate the romance languages. All my homies fuck with the Germanic languages.
It stated that the intersection of light and dark.
There's no music.
What the hell? Are you sorry there's no music?
No, there is no music. You came at a time. They're having a very serious talk about how she's gonna, like, destroy the world and how the little girl's actually me.
500 years.
Yeah, it's actually me. And how 500 years ago she stabbed me in the gut and put me in a sarcophagus. There's no music.
When you edit this for YouTube, you should put music over this.
I'm leaving this. I'm actually gonna just mute everything.
Are at the center of that chaos, allowing you to continue to exist.
She's
a danger that cannot.
I don't
be accepted.
Hate him.
It's true.
It is not true. See, she stabbed me in the gut with a rapier, as seen in D&D 5e.
What about 4e?
I don't know if it's
3. 2? 1?
Probably.
D&D 1?
Will never fall into the hands of another.
I wonder how much the weapons have changed from 1, the first edition of D&D, to the 5th edition.
Will never fall into the hands of another.
Bayonetta, spit in your mouth.
It is time that this is brought
okay,
to
I gotta
an
beat
end.
My thing.
That you are brought to an end. You did it. It is our charge as witches to protect the treasures of the clan by any means necessary, even if it means burning every. This island to a crisp.
I'm really beginning to hate missiles. You know, I have no idea what the hell you girls got going on here. But you don't mind if I take this off your hands, do you? Get in, Cinecita.
Mommy.
Okay.
Theresa. Bayonetta. Time is of the essence. This can wait no longer.
They didn't even say, like, how they died, and she just shot off the missiles even though she didn't have the control. Okay. If she damages me, I still... How did that not do damage? It might only work on angels and she's not me. It would be interesting though, like, I guess they already did that with Joy, but like having an angel version, like, of me, but they already had the Joy, like, basically copycat me for a little bit. And now I know the moon stages are angel, like, angelic versions of the witches. This is getting very messy. So hopefully this is a cutscene, so when I die in like 10 seconds, I can come back to it. Where is her weave at? Like, what was she even using it for? Fastest hot dog shooter in the fastest hot dog shooter on this side of Mississippi. Have you seen that video?
Yes, and he swallows like two.
It's more than two. He swallows like.
That's the video that Jerma, he's like, I think about that. He's like, he goes, he's like, throw out and be like, regurgitated, but I guess this is the proper term.
Yeah.
You know what video has been running through my brain a lot lately?
Yeah.
There's two videos. First one is Soulja Boy's like, in Dubai, he's like, hey yo, it's Soulja Boy, I'm in Dubai.
I got the new shoes,
Tony got nine! One day at work, I kept repeating that over and over again. We were like, what the fuck are you talking about? Then, it's the video of the boys, and they're looking at the like package of meat, and he's like, it said it got 83% lean in it! That's a good video.
I know that audio, but I don't think I've ever seen that video.
It's like a bunch of like, they're probably like 10. And they're like, I don't know where they are, but they have like a package of meat. And it's like, it has to be like a turkey or something, like turkey meat. I got 83% lean! I got that lean!
Oh, this was verse 3. How many verses have I got? Hopefully this is a It said saving, so hopefully that's a checkpoint.
Thank you.
I have enough to make any healing items, so he's just gonna... Ooh. I didn't know there was gonna be two. I didn't even try. I'm dead. Kept it alive for a while, but it ended in the end. Checkpoint, please. Yes. Another thing is that I think it's interesting that a main staple of being an Umbran witch is witch time, and yet Jean never uses it against me. If she tries to do two. There we go. Silver, okay. I got platinum for time. And so who made her guns? Because clearly it's not just like a witch thing to have those guns, because Rodan made them for me.
Now it's decided. So it is. The fear is still not gone from your eyes. Fear? The memories you held. 500 years are the source of your fear. They cloud your vision. But now, you've accepted your fate. That is how you bested me. That is why you possess the most beloved of Umbran treasures. That is why you possess the left eye. We fought for this stone, and because of it, everyone died. That gem brings back so many memories.
Jean, it says Jean and Cereza on it.
Our treasured left eye will never fall into the hands of another. I will not stand for the wild ambition of a treacherous Lumen sage who disrupted our age-old balance. Your path ends here. Do not fear your fate. Stand, Theresa.
was like she was talking to her, but she was disappeared.
As friends. But as time passed, perhaps even my eyes were clouded with fear. We were. Do not fear your fate. Stand, Ceresa. Stand and open your eyes. For with every truth, there is another one to be seen.
Oh. She loved you this whole time, and I didn't know. But still, for some reason, you haven't given me a reason on why you hate me.
Is it over? What? Not like you don't scare
you're
the
alive.
Shit out of me all the time.
Ceresa. I don't know whether to shoot you or to take you to Vegas for good luck, Cheshire.
Give me more credit than that. If you must know where L-U-K-A Luca is concerned, there's no such thing as luck. Only skill.
Flashback sequence. That's so cute!
You didn't expect me to trust bitches.
I mean witches.
Witches, did you, Bayonetta?
How's the little one?
Out like a light. But okay other than that. What about you? You really think I'm gonna let myself be seen in public with a girl looking all beat up like that?
Oh. I look dreadful, do I?
Huh?
You'll have to learn to wipe that stupid look off your face, or I'll never let you keep chasing me around this world. Got that? Luca?
Now that's more like it.
Silver, 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 and I'm gonna get a stone. Chapter 15, A Tower of Truth. Let's go ahead and save. And then we're going to take a tour to the Gates of Hell. I think we're just going to buy every single item that he has.
Hey, check this out. What are you buying? Heard that in a game once.
So, what are you buying is actually my favorite voice acting line of all time. It's a reference to Resident Evil 4 shopkeeper. And he goes, "What are you selling? What are you buying?" But yeah, it's definitely like one of the best all-time lines. Alright, let's see how many what things I can buy from here. I can only buy one of those. But yeah, we're just gonna. I haven't been using lollipops that much in the game, but since we're coming up on like the last levels, I have a feeling we're gonna be needing them. So we're just gonna buy up the whole shop. before we spend the last 100,000, we could get one more. We could get one more of these items. But none of them seem too interesting to me. Moon of Mahakala is actually really good, but I don't. It's gonna be another 100k in order to earn it. And like I said, we're trying to not redo levels. So we're going to not get that, and we're gonna focus on filling our inventory of these. And then we're gonna buy some techniques. Alright, let's see what we got. This is new. So in the air, let's try it out. Whoa, that's actually like really. Whoa. Okay, that's interesting. I just need to remember that I have it. And then what's afterburner kick again? Press A immediately after executing the jump. No, I don't want anything that does airtime. Stiletto might be good though. These are double tapping. Heel stomp. Heel stomp for sure. While moving backward to forward. These are just like, they're tricky because they're like more and more complicated. Press and hold X while holding that. Okay, let's try. Again, it's just another one that doesn't work very well with it doesn't work very well with breakdance. Breakdance breaks a lot of things because a lot of things work with holding the trigger. It's gonna be too tricky to use that one consistently. Same with the both of these use that move. So these are both double tap. I might as well grab them. Now we got most of the techniques, and we have a full inventory of items. So we can. Pretty good going into some of the last levels. Let's go ahead and save one more time. With 122 halos.
Looks like someone's expecting us. Awfully nice of them to roll out the red carpet.
Luca, you need to get one thing straight.
Yeah, I know. I won't look after you, so don't screw up. I got things under control.
Let's go. Stay next to me.
Thank you.
What?
Daddy, it's Daddy.
So she can.
Daddy.
She can hear him too.
Can't you hear him? Okay, Daddy, I'm coming, and I'll bring Mummy with me.
Little one, wait.
This way, Mummy.
Little one.
And what, Luca is suddenly left out of the
little loop. One.
Cerecita! Bayonetta! Damn it!
Oh, hey, my health bar. My health bar is down to the second. Second this dash forward one is really good because it seems to like break their concentration. Yeah, it just doesn't boost any damage. But let's take a look at what we have to offer here. Yeah, I'm trying to do stiletto. Block towards an enemy. Oh, okay. I was doing back and forward, but I'm just supposed to do forward. Oh, wait. That's not stiletto. This is what I'm just trying to heal stuff while moving backward to forward. Press A. Okay. So. Either switch weapons or use rest time and my two options. So anytime you kill any of the ones that are flaming, you take damage. But his flames are extinguished, so that makes it a little nicer. I'm glad that's the end of that first, because I don't know that I could have taken another round of that. I want to make sure I didn't miss anything down here. First one is the sword. You guys are gonna come to life, and I'm not gonna have a good time with it. Or not, that's fine. Huge industrial machine is visible. It seems to be set to do something via automation, but it's not operating at the moment. Okay. I don't know how you know that it's for or how you know it's on. I mean, besides it just being a machine, what makes sense to it? Or it's just a simple thing. These guys are gonna come to life.
Yep.
Looks like he makes like an alpine portal on the ground when he comes through like that. Okay, I can use your gauntlets. Again, not sure if this ever explained why I can't use why I can't use Witch Time when I dodge them. Witch Time only activates when I get hit by them because I have a special accessory. No practice. A dizzying amount of information is streaming over the control terminal's monitor. Some machine must be on right now. These techniques are actually coming way more in handy than I thought they would. I should have probably snagged them a little bit earlier. Alex said, "Who's there?" Nice. Oh, I got hit once. Ugh, it's inverted. Can't handle inverted. It's only inverted on the horizontal. I could just switch it in there. I try to use inverted controls, even though I fixed it. All right. Now that it's fixed from the start, it'll be easier. Even though I dodged it, it put me in slow motion, it still killed me. It didn't give me witch time, but it did, like, slow down the screen to show, okay, yeah, you dodged it, but you're still gonna take damage, but yeah, you dodged it. We're kind of committing to this one, so let's use our small green ones. One thing. Turn on this right on the forehead, right in the weak spot. Oh, I had zero health, and I was not going to use my big green concoction, which definitely has a name. Take that book, though. stupid in here. They've simply blocked out areas that aren't currently in use. It doesn't feel like Sarasa is here either. Despite the building crumbling, security shows no signs of scrambling. There are no alarms, it's almost too quiet around here. The fire! The area of effect of the fire killed me. Two wicked weasel around. Basically the level that I did in Paradiso where I'm fighting. There's no like alpine portal down there, right? Really? I don't see one. Here we go. A very beautiful statue. Ooh, health upgrade? Yeah! Nice. Here. Well, there's gates of hell, but I don't really need it right now. I just have to hop over the beginning of Toy Story platforms. Thank you. that's the way I think. Or something. The other stuff down here. Red hot shot, I need that. Shit. That crow was like right for the picking. Okay. I almost fell off the face of the earth. Was I on that? Or I guess it just spat me out. That's an Alfheim portal. No, those are jets on the bottom. But I mean, there's gotta be some sort of collectible. Let's take a look at it. But without falling off the edge, please. There's a verse. Goodbye. I try to do the bird. These areas still didn't trigger the verse. This one? Still not. Come on. Golem with new forms.
Nice.
come on, I stunned it and I'm not gonna hit it. See if we're gonna do volleyball again. Do one quick trick from this. Any secrets? There's something, oh, okay. There's something all the way around. But it wasn't on one of the platforms, it was in between. Wait, what? Where is it? I passed it. Oh, I have to fly over here. There you go. Oh, you gotta be kidding. All right. No platforms to land on. Okay. Whoa! It killed me! After all that? So that's the first time that falling off the edge actually kills you. And it did not save my stuff, so I'm gonna get that one real fast. So first, I gotta get this one. Whoa. Go, get the moon pearl. And we're just gonna fly over just to make sure that we're doing it the safe way. Wanted to get squished and then ran away. Right. So yeah, now we're just gonna fly back. Yes. Hello. Can I help you? He doesn't really want to be on stream. He just wants other table scratches. What does it want me to do? I was using the panther like, and since it came on screen. Don't question it. You see red gems giving off a red hue, you just break them. Also, only my shadow's on the wall, not the balls. Can I actually jump on that? Is it? This, I could definitely jump on. And this is a super path. Nope, just kidding. Okay, but can I really not jump on this one? Invisible walls all around. Alright, one last thing to try to jump on. Nope. Into Paradiso again? Chapter 15. And there's two verses. Used a ton of items. Yeah, of course. First time. Save there. I mean, that whole level gives you 35 grand, which is a lot, but I mean, it also took a lot of time. Right. Let's go ahead and start.
What follows those living in the light is nothing but the profound. Empty darkness born from the shadow that grows longer as they approach the brilliant radiance. To truly see, your eyes must be open to both light and dark. Don't you agree, my dear child?
I could have sworn that was just his finger. Like, he's using his finger as lipstick. I do want to pause just for a second. I'm really curious as to, like, I don't know, like, someone who's really into philosophy or, like, really into religion, on how this reflects in, like, what, we'll say, like, what religious text this is closest to, and, like, what the philosophical and religious weight is of the story. Because to me, it is just a battle of, like, witches and warlocks, angels and devils. But I feel like there are some people who would have a lot more insight.
Mommy!
Little one.
You've arrived. My dear, sweet Cereza. My, why the grim face, my dear? As a child, your smile was warmer than the sun.
So, you are the last of the Lumen Sages.
I am indeed.
And he has peacock
My feathers. Name is Baldur. But if you so choose, you may address me as Father. There is much you have forgotten. It has been 500 years since we last met. If your memories were still intact, this would have been a much more emotional reconciliation.
How did you get the girl?
Where shall I begin? We, the Lumen Sages, and your Umbra Witches, have long been the overseers of history, each bearing witness with their own eye. This is how our universes existence was preserved. However, for 500 years, you have been exiled from the world's affairs. You are the left eye of the eyes of the world.
Could you dispense with the riddles and just tell me what these sodding eyes actually are?
Your years of slumber have caused you to forget many things. Even as we stand on the verge of the resurrection of the Creator. The resurrection of Jubilees. There is but one way to return your epic of forgotten memories and open your eye of the overseer. Your uncorrupted eye had to be exposed to the history. Could not see. Your battles, your struggles, everything you've experienced in this town has been a stepping stone for your enlightenment. It has all been done for the left eye.
I've had enough of your philosophical pretensions. I won't ask again. Where did you get the girl?
Your question has been answered. All this has been done to awaken the left eye. For that, you had to see yourself once more.
Is she just getting that?
You are truly beyond salvation, Sage.
Ah, salvation. Such a curious word. I mark the path to salvation with light. However, no matter how brilliant that light grows, the darkness within the human heart grows even darker. Light, dark, and chaos between. Three realities, once split, shall be brought together to create a new universe in the image of the old. To these ends, leading to the Festival of Resurrection 500 years ago, I fanned the flames of terror, spurring on the witch hunts. However, despite the people's belief in the return of Jubileus, the Creator, the left eye was out of reach.
And also, speaking in like D&D terms, there's a light, he's saying light, dark, and chaos are the three realms, which is Paradiso, Inferno, and the human realm. But like, there isn't a neutral party or a like lawful party in this. It's just like, okay, well, there's evil people, there's good people, and there is just humans that are like batshit, do whatever they want. It's like, you'd think that like humans might be like neutral based on like their free will, but then you can also say that they're also chaotic because they have the ability to do what they want. I don't know. It is just kind of strange to think of like humans, the like epitome of chaos, when the Lumen Sages and the Umber Witches seem a lot more chaotic with how they act.
Since then, I have devoted myself to this town's prosperity. And now, it is time for my preparations to bear fruit. Jubileus will be resurrected. We will become the eyes of the world, and a new universe will take hold.
Puppy!
I could never call the man behind this nightmare father.
Great speech, big guy.
Luca.
Getting a bit ahead of ourselves, aren't we, Mr. Big Shot Ithaval Executive? Salvation, light. You take this entrepreneurial philosophy a bit seriously, don't you? But it's all diarrhea of the mouth, if you ask me. History is littered with famous genocidal figures, just like you. Or, should I say, infamous genocidal figures.
You must be Luca, journalist extraordinaire. I must say, I'm truly impressed you've made it this far, child. Like father, like son, I swear.
What?
Luca, Luca, Luca. Your father had problems with my philosophies. It's fine to investigate, but when malicious rumors start to spread, I must see to it that they come to a stop. For being kind enough to ascertain that my long-lost eraser was
so he killed his dad just because he was spreading bad rumors.
I granted him his final wish, and accepted his permanent resignation.
And also, what is that supposed to mean? Like, oh, like, investigating is fine, but like, uncovering the truth, that's not okay. The whole point of, what's the point of investigating it, especially if you're an investigative journalist, if you're not going to try to make the things you believe public. And it's not like he was that big of a threat because nobody believed him or Luca.
Bastard!
You are of no use. However, I am not without dignity. I will allow you to die in the same way as your father.
Lucas survived worse than that.
I guess my plan has gone right out the window. Such a shame that sacrifice had to be made. But if destiny is not fulfilled soon, this tragedy will be repeated ad nauseam. Speaking of tragedy, I suppose you've met John. While she sealed you away and kept you from trouble, after falling into our hands, she's been incredibly useful. Although her distinct lack of obedience required a bit of mental reprogramming. Her tragic end led you directly to me, just as planned.
So she was bringing
the time for awakening the left eye is soon. Fear not, my dear, sweet Silas.
He's got sage time.
Do not fear your fate. Stand tall. Realize your true potential.
I like that. The way he said potential. Potential.
Cereza, we are one, my child.
Does he get another health bar? Max Burns. get the health from. I'm ready for the same button, so I'm hoping it's the same. Nope, it's not. Birdie hen? Oh, the centipede. I wish, like, if I got an axe bonus, it would make this health bar a little bit lower. Combs his hair like he got hard. I just imagine, like, just the lipstick splatting against his forehead. It's like, okay, well, it wasn't actually made of metal, so it just kind of splattered on my forehead, and now I have, it looks like I was at, looks like I fell asleep at a party.
Give you credit, Bayonetta. You never cease to impress.
You haven't seen the half of it.
I've seen enough. about wraps it up, huh?
Not yet.
Time to return Cereza. But now she'll be better having had an experience with Bayonetta.
Be afraid, little one. The nightmare is over. Everything was just a dream. You're a strong little girl. There is nothing you cannot overcome.
Mommy, did you find it? What you were looking for?
Yes, I found it. So don't you worry anymore. You just keep your treasure safe, too. Sweet dreams, little one.
There you go. The birth of Cereza from Bayonetta 3.
The stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words. Never lose it. Understand, little one?
Oh, so now she's actually remembering all the things safe, that she
close to your heart. I'm not afraid anymore, Mummy. No matter what, there's nothing I cannot do.
Yeah, I made
Bayonetta,
it better.
What's happening to you?
And now it is done. The right eye oversees the life.
Is this the ending?
The left eye oversees the dark. Two eyes to oversee the world. It was never the woman known as Bayonetta that I set my sights upon. It was you as a child, Cereza, that I saw. For she was the one who saw the world through innocent eyes, and she was the one who could give rise to a new history. It was her energy that could awaken the left eye. This has all worked out splendid. Let us begin, Cereza. The time is at hand. Now, the resurrection of Jubileus shall be completed. We are the eyes. Overseeing the world. We are the eyes, overseeing a new era, a new reality.
to which we will devote ourselves eternally.
But so it didn't mess with Luca at all, but it messed with her past and somehow brought him back to life, is what I'm not really sure about. Take silver. I also have to remember that there's no, I mean, at least it doesn't seem like there's a time limit on that, so I could just theoretically just keep waiting for the perfect tens. Oh, just fully take my mini off of the board. That'd be a really scary thing for like a dungeon master to do. Okay, like, so you guys are in the middle of this battle. You're standing here. Let me just take that. I'm not going to tell you what is happening to us just yet, but let's go. Alright. Really don't want to end on a cliffhanger, but it is getting really late, and I'm not sure how long it's going to take me to complete the epilogue. So we're going to save it here for the night, and then tomorrow we're going to finish off our Bayonetta 1 saga with the epilogue Requiem. From there, we're going to switch over to Bayonetta 2, and so we'll play Bayonetta 2 on... We're going to play Bayonetta 2 tomorrow. I'm pretty sure we're also going to have Bayonetta 2 on Monday as well. But yeah, so just look forward to that, and I'll see you guys on the next episode of Countdown to Bayonetta 3. Alright, you guys have a good night. See you soon.